Breakfast, lunch, and dinner, including attractions, within 50 ringgit. Let's go!
Yeah. Let's go!
Let's go eat!
It has been operating since 24 years ago and is famous for its nasi kandar, of course.
It's like nasi kandar. So nasi kandar pita is basically mama here in Malaysia. They have a lot of food, so nasi kandar, roti canai, mee goreng, and etc. That's a lot of food.
John, Nana, I'm very hungry. Let's order now.
Let's go.
Ramadan, you won't really see me and Nana eating that much since we're fasting. So these goons are gonna eat in front of us, but it's okay because
we're used to it.
Spend like 36 ringgit for just four of us. It's very cheap.
Now we're done with breakfast, so we're gonna like drive to an attraction nearby here, about like a 15 minutes drive. First, we wanna show you like the cultural stuff that we have in Malaysia, so let's go.
Alright, so right now we're going to Pasar Seni. Pasar Seni is quite a very cultural place. It has these traditional crafts and you'll see.
Hi guys, so we're in Central Market right now, which is known as Pasar Seni. It's freaking hot, so let's go in.
Without women.
No,
I cannot live without women.
Really. This is like the flea market, but like the outside version of Pasar Seni. I think there's like more food choices here, like a little bit more art, like more street food. The kind of thing that you can see here is like a juice chain. But besides that, they sell like pretty like traditional clothes, and I'm pretty sure like there are more people here than usual because Raya is coming up.
Okay, so we just left Central Market. It's kind of jam right now. But what do you guys think?
It's hot. It's really, really hot.
I mean, it wasn't that bad because it is air-conditioned. So you can get out of the hot Malaysian weather. She got her hand red. What was it? She's going to live a long life.
I'm going to live a long, healthy life. And I'm going to be a very lucky person. Happy-go-lucky. Yeah.
Where are we going now?
We're going to Habika. Now we are arrived at Habika. We are at this place called Ifrut Village.
Yeah, and Ifrut Village is more of a food court than an actual restaurant. They have many different types of food here, from Malay food to Chinese food. And interesting about this place that the public health company itself did their research and hiring these famous hawkers and workers from kopitiams to sell their food here. So it's more of street food than it is an actual, you know, restaurant.
So we have just ordered. We ordered like meatball soup, chicken meatball, by the way. And it's quite cheap actually. There's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7,
9.
Okay, 9, 10. There's like 10 chicken meatballs in there. And it's only like 4 ringgit 30 cents. Cheap, right?
So I just ordered a curry laksa. And what I get is a huge amount of noodles. And some seafood, the cuttlefish, and some tofu with just 10 ringgit.
Because my stomach is full, so I just ordered chendol for me, and it's just 5 ringgit.
Hey. We just finished, they've just finished having lunch at the Eat Food Village. What do you think about it since we didn't eat?
I think it was decent.
Oh, so
it's not like the best, but it's decent.
And it's still pretty cheap. I mean, for the food, the amount of food that you get, it's crazy cheap actually. And that was one of the many malls in Kuala Lumpur. Habika is quite special because it has a lot of these local brands and not really handmade, but how to say, like these local companies that come and sell their merchandise. There are a lot of these like little stalls, you can say, that sell a lot of different like little items. I don't really know how to say it, but it's interesting. A lot can be found there.
Okay, so now we're going to the most iconic place in Kuala Lumpur. Movie theater, high-end stuff. You can buy like Chanel, Gucci, Balenciaga, etc. And there's, you can buy groceries here also, which is like a good thing in a shopping mall. It has everything.
And it's also Ting Ting and Lucien's first time.
Because they are not from KL.
They're not from KL. You see, I'm Ting Ting.
Yeah.
I'm not KL guy. I'm not KL guy.
The only place he has been to is DK Senza.
Came back from KLCC.
Our experience there is quite amazing. We saw like a lot of high-end shops, which is Dior and
Gucci.
Chanel. It's Chanel. Yisan went in there because she wants to like look around.
She wanted to buy shoes. Both Chanel and Dior.
It's quite an amazing experience because there's like two of our friends that never came there before.
Yeah, it's kind of weird to see to know people that haven't really been to KLCC. Mm-hmm. Even though they're Malaysian.
It's been there for like years.
You know? Because it's such a normal thing for us. Like we can literally go to KLCC
anytime. Yeah, it's like our second home.
Yeah. It's almost book of pasta for us.
Yeah.
And they are hungry. So let's go to dinner, y'all.
Let's go dinner. So now we're going to Sri Niwarna Maju, which is in Jalan Ampang. It's Jalan Telawi.
Yeah. Lunch and dinner under our budget. How much do we have left?
We have eaten about 40 ringgit each person.
Okay. We have 10 ringgit extra, you can buy souvenirs. Bubble tea.
So we have overcome the challenge that we made just now by spending our money, our 50 for just a day.
So yeah, so we show you guys how to stay in KL under 50 ringgit. Yeah.
Yeah,
good.
It was good for us because we got food.
Yeah, they finally book a parcel. Good for them.
Okay, he's tired already, we should go.
Okay, bye.
Okay, bye.